Welcome to Freedive Live, episode number 30. My name is Ted Hardy. I'm the founder of Immersion Freediving as well as freedivingsafety.com. I've been a full-time instructor since 2009. I'm an instructor trainer for performance freediving, and I'm also a competitive freediver as well. So if you're not familiar with the show, the way the show works is I typically start off with an entertaining or educational story from my career. I pick one, possibly two topics to discuss in depth, and then I answer your questions at the end of the show. So if you have not heard of or visited my new website, freedivingsafety.com, you definitely should. It's a free course that goes over the risks of the sport, talks about you'll learn the truth about blackout, you'll learn how to tell if you're wearing too much weight, very common among many freediver and spear fishermen. You'll learn if you're breathing in such a way that would increase your risk for having a blackout, so you obviously avoid doing that. You're going to learn what is a loss of motor drill, what's a blackout, what did it look like? If you saw someone have one, what would you see? And then ultimately, if your buddy had a loss of motor control or blackout, how would you fix it? Not only do you get all of that, right, there's a quiz in there, and if you pass the quiz, you're going to get an email with discounts from 9 of the sponsors of freedivingsafety.com. So learn to save your buddy, learn to save yourself, or save some money. Either way, there's no reason not to visit freedivingsafety.com. That is basically my new mission, is to teach more people about safe freediving than anyone on the planet, and the website freedivingsafety.com is going to be the vehicle that's hopefully going to allow me to get there. So game plan for today, I'll be starting off, instead of a story, I'm actually going to be showing you a video relevant to the topic today. So I want to show you a video of one of my students rescuing a spear fisherman from a blackout, right? So you're going to see the video, kind of see kind of what happened. I'll be kind of explaining that, so you'll get to see that firsthand. That ties in very well to what we're actually doing today, which is teaching you how to rescue someone from a blackout. If they have a blackout, what the heck are you supposed to do, right? Are you supposed to shake them? Are you supposed to slap them? Are you supposed to, you know, do CPR? Do you have to put oxygen on them? Do they have to go to the hospital? Like, what are you supposed to do if you see something like that? Okay. And then at the end of that, obviously, as always, I will be answering your questions. So do me a favor, for those that are watching right now, let me know in the comments, are you watching this live or are you watching this on the replay? Because I'm always interested to find out, are you, you know, how much of the people are tuning in like when it's happening right now, or you're just tuning in at a later date. So if you let me know in the comments if you're watching it live on the replay, that will help me out. Okay. Before we get started, the most popular course I have, online course, I've just recently hit over 1,000 people in it, is, you can get it right there, is onlinefreedivingcourses.com. So I'll show you what it looks like. Basically, here's the deal with this course, right? Whether you're what kind of freediver you are, freediver, spear fisherman, line diver, whatever it is, we all want more time underwater. And this quickest way to immediately get more bottom time is make sure you're taking the biggest breath, right? So one of the first things I teach my students is how to take a 20 to 30% bigger breath. And when I teach them how to do that, every single time they go, holy crap, that's the biggest breath I've ever taken. I've never had a student go like, what's the big deal? That's as much air as I take every time. They're always blown away by how much of a bigger breath they can take. So that's what you can learn in the program. It's super simple. You just go to that website right there. And then what you're gonna see is, woo, not that. You're going to see that, right? And so, yeah, then you just put your name and email address and then click got this, and that's it, right? And that's how you get it. My most popular course that I have. Now, let me make this thing go away. All right, so so now I'm going to show you a video of a blackout that a student sent me. So the video, just I'll set up the video so it makes a little more sense. So the video footage is from a GoPro mask, which I love, because so many spearfishermen wear GoPro masks, which is why we see so many blackout rescues and stuff now, because they all got GoPros on, which is awesome. So my student and one other guy were spearfishing on the rigs. And so my student shot a fish and was going to swim to the boat to put it in the cooler. And when he left, he said, don't dive. I'll be back in just a second. I gotta put this in the boat and then I'm gonna come back. Because he's a student of mine and he wants to be watching his buddy. Doesn't want the guy diving without someone watching him, right? So the buddy's like, whatever, I don't need a babysitter. And then he goes, does his dive, Right, so this guy does a dive. My student is on the boat. Okay, and you can imagine something happens. Right, now the couple things before you see the video, I want you to think about. Think about if someone were to, you know, someone swims back to the boat and the guy does a dive, comes up and has a blackout. In a typical situation, think how far away that boat would be from where that blackout happened. I mean, how often are you shooting fish 10 foot from the boat? Probably not very, right? So you're going to see how lucky this was because of the setup, because they were on the rigs, right? They were tied off to the rig. All right, so yeah, I guess just enough talk. I'll put this through. So bear with me. Do, 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 do. Boom. Make me go away. Oh no, we're gonna watch that one later. Yeah. All right, so let me know in the comments if you guys can see this when I start playing it. Sometimes I mess this up a little bit. All right, so it should be playing. Let me know if you guys can see that. So he's just starting his dive. And I timed it. It's a long dive. It's about a minute and a half, right? I mean, that's not a super long dive, but I mean, he's down there a good time. Thank you for letting me know you can hear and see. What's up, buddy? Thanks for all your help getting the show sorted, buddy. So again, my student is on the boat, putting the fish in the cooler. So he's starting to head up. Boom, there's the surface right there. And that's his face going in the water. That's my student putting him on his back. You see, let go of the gun. That's my student taking his mask off. And that's my student slapping him, tapping him on the face and encouraging him to breathe. All right, so make this guy go away, make me come back. Look at that. Almost like I know what I'm doing. So yeah, that's a pretty powerful video, right? So a couple things you notice. You saw how close that boat was to where the guy was, right? That's really lucky. I mean, the average person, if they're diving in a two-person team, the guy goes, I'm going to swim back to the boat, put my fish on the boat. That boat's going to be way the hell away from where they're diving. So that guy is super lucky by a couple things. Number one, that my student, the boat was anchored so close to where they were diving. But really, he's lucky that my student had taken my course or a course, that he was, even though he was dealing with the fish, he was watching the guy. Cause if you remember, he told the guy, wait till I get back. And he saw the guy did a dive and he's like, well, whatever on the boat. So he's dealing with the fish. And then he saw what happened. And literally that guy put his face in the water and within about 4 seconds, that guy jumped off the boat and was able to get to him. Put him on his back, take the mask off, and do the whole rescue. Guy was fine. The thing was, is the guy didn't believe he blacked out, and he continued diving, and he wouldn't stop. one of the things that's very common about blackout rescues is they don't know that they blacked out. In fact, they refuse to believe that they blacked out. I've seen that multiple, because you see all these videos on YouTube, the guy comes up and has a blackout and he's rescued because everyone's got GoPro masks on. And he's like, what do you mean I didn't black out? I felt fine. And they're like, no, you blacked out. They're like, no, you blacked out. And he's like, no, I didn't. So one of the rules is if you have a loss of motor or a blackout, you're done diving for the day because you are much more likely to have a worse loss of motor control or a blackout. All right. Hey, so do me a favor. If you like the video, hit the like button. And if you have, if you have any impressions on what you thought of that, if you've ever seen anything like that, let me know in the comments. And then also start thinking ahead. At the end of the presentation, I will be answering your questions. So if you have questions that you would like me to answer, go ahead and put those in the comments. I have the ability to scroll through and look at all of the comments at the end of the show. And if there are any in there, that I will answer those at the end. All right. Moving on to the next section, we'll be getting into this idea of what you're supposed to do if someone has a blackout. One of my newest courses is the online courses is the Breath Hold Secrets. If you have not taken a freediving class, if you're listening to this right now and you have not taken a freediving class, you're crazy not to sign up for the Bigger Breath Program. It's only $39, right? So, Breath Hold Secrets program. Right. If you've ever talked to anyone taking a freediving course, they're gonna go on and on about how long they held their breath. Right. They held their breath. They doubled how long they held their breath, or whatever they held their breath for. They can't believe how much bottom time they have. And one of the reasons where you're gonna learn in any freediving class, padding, Howie, SSI, PFI, FI, whatever, in every freediving class, that instructor, like me, knows the secret to long breath holds. And the secret is very simple. The secret is it's not what you do during the breath hold. It's what you do before the breath hold, right? Every freediving class, you're gonna learn that secret, right? You're gonna learn what you're supposed to do to hold your breath longer. And that's what you're gonna learn in my Breath Hold Secrets program, right? So it's only $39. How do you get it? Again, you go to the online freedivingcourses.com. When you give me a second. So when you go to this website and you type in your email address, the next thing it'll take you to is this page, right? So it's just the Breath Hold Secrets page. So not only get access to the biggest secret in breath holding, you're gonna get all this other stuff, right? The Breath Hold Secret bundle. You're gonna get access to the Breath Hold Secrets program. You're gonna get access to the safety program. You're gonna get access to the 1 hour, my greatest hits from the TED Talks, which is my old TV show I did. It's basically the best hour out of 20 hours, because you probably don't want to watch 20 hours of me talking. There's also how to activate your most primal reflex. This is a video that I made for Spearfishing magazine to coincide with the articles that I wrote for them. And it's how to make the mammalian dive reflex work for you instead of against you on your next trip. And then there's an interview with 3-time world record holder Ashley. All right, so again, it's only $39, and you can access that by going to that online freediving courses.com, and then you can access it there. All right, so let's get into the rescue, right? How what you're supposed to do if your buddy has a loss of motor control or a blackout. Now, before we get into how we would save someone if they had a loss of motor control or a blackout, we have to go over something else. Because knowing how to save someone, don't get me wrong, that's awesome. You know, when you take a freediving my class or any class, they're gonna drill you and test you that you know how to do the mechanics of these blackout rescues. But what you need to understand is taking a freediving class doesn't make you safe. A lot of people think, I have this all the time with parents, right? The parents call and they're worried about their son or their daughter and want them to take a freediving course. I'm like, no. If you're worried about your son or daughter, you need to understand, them taking this freediving course ain't going to make them safe, right? What's good, what the freediving course does is it makes the person they're diving with safe, because if their buddy has a blackout, they know what to do, right? But that doesn't really help you, because if you have a blackout, you need to have your buddies that know what to do. And on top of all of that, you need to actually be there, right? And this is, I think, a thing that's missed. A lot of people take these freediving classes, they get all this information, they know how to do these blackout rescues, and they think they're safe, and then they go out diving, and they go spearfishing, and this one goes that way, and this one goes that way. if you're not there when the buddy hits the surface to see that they have a blackout, how can you do anything about it, right? I mean, if you got two people in the water and the one guy comes up, as soon as he comes up, the other guy's like, sweet, I see a hogfish, and he goes and tears off after that hogfish, and that guy has a blackout, the other guy's down there trying to wrangle this hogfish. Like, it doesn't matter that the guy underwater knows how to do a perfect blackout rescue. You're not there, right? I mean, what if the one guy goes this way, one guy goes this way, and no one's watching anyone? It doesn't matter that in your head you know how to do these rescues. So the idea is I'm going to show you how to do the rescue, but you also got to understand that information is worthless unless you're actually doing proper free diving supervision. So we're going to go over that kind of quickly. There's three main things that you want to do, right? So number one is you want to dive what we call one up, one down. And that concept is as simple as what it sounds like, right? When I say, like when I go to, do a presentation, maybe the Blue Wild and got a room full of spearfishing, or I go to the Miami, the South Florida Freedivers, and I start talking about, you guys need to dive one up, one down, right? You already know what that means. That means that when one person's down, the other person stays up. And then when that person comes to the surface, you're right there. And that's it. That's all it is. And so when I explain that to spear fishermen, you should be diving one up, one down, it's not like they go, oh my gosh, that's brilliant. That's brilliant, Ted. I'm going to start doing that tomorrow. They all know they're supposed to do that. They don't want to. Not going to, right? Not going to do that. No one I know does that, right? And so that's the issue, right? They know they're supposed to, but they're just not going to, right? So we need to be diving one up, one down. Okay, on top of that, we also need to be in a situation so when that person comes up, we are what we call close enough to grab, within arm's reach, which is about 3 foot, right? If you got 50 foot long arms, then you can be 50 foot away from your buddy. If you got normal human size arm, that's going to be about 3 foot, right? You want to be close enough to grab them. Why? Because you're going to learn in just a second how to rescue someone from a blackout, but that requires that you can grab them. If they're 50 foot away sinking down to the bottom of the ocean, you can get your GoPro and you can film it. Yeah, that's what that guy said. The guy's sinking to the bottom really fast, right? Unless you're close enough to grab them, you can't do anything about it, right? So we need to be diving one up, one down. We need to be close enough to grab. And on top of those two, we also need to watch that person for no less than 30 seconds. Why? Because here's something that a lot of people don't fully understand. 90% of the blackouts happen at the surface after that person's taken 2 or 3 breaths. So most of the blackouts I've seen in my career, the person hits the surface, gives me an okay sign, and then boom, out they go. So most of the blackouts I've seen, the person hits the surface, looks fine, takes one breath, takes a second breath, and oftentimes will look me square in the eye, give me a no, and then they go out, right? So most of the blackouts happen at the surface after 2 or 3 breaths, right? So because of that, that's why we need to watch for 30 seconds, right? So for instance, I know of free divers and spear fishermen that say things like, yeah, I do one up, one down. I'm totally on board, right, Ted? When my guy goes down, I'm sitting at the surface, and then as soon as he makes it to the surface, I know he's okay, so then I leave. Well, if 90% of the blackouts happen after the surface, after 2 or 3 breaths, it's almost like he's dying by himself, because most of the problems happen after they get to the surface. And it's not intuitive, right? You as a free diver, you don't come up from a dive. And when you think the dive's over, when you hit the surface, you're like, whew, I made it. No, you actually just entered. You just stepped into the most dangerous portion of the dive is the minute your head hits the surface. Because now you're in a situation where you are most likely to encounter that problem. All right, so the three things are, you want to be diving one up, one down. You want to be close enough to grab. And you want to watch for no less than 30 seconds, right? So going backward on that rule of nines we talked about, 90% of the issues happen at the surface after 2 or 3 breaths. 9% happen between 15 feet and the surface, right? So I call that kind of swimming pool depths, right? So 9% are going to happen between 15 feet and the surface. And then 0.9% as deep as 82 feet or 25 meters. But that's going to be pretty much, that's competitive freedivers only that are diving crazy deep, 300-400 feet. Yeah, so 90% at the surface, 9% at 15 feet, 5 meters, and then 0.9% as deep as 82 feet or 25 meters. All right, so the idea is I'll show you how to rescue someone, but you have to be close to do anything about it, right? So here's the thing you have to think about, especially if you're spearfishing. I mean, think about this. Think about the guy that you normally dive with. And let's say he just said, all right, I'm going to watch you on your dive. And you do a dive. And while you're down there, a grouper, something goes, a wahoo goes flying by. Is that person going to be there for you when you hit the surface? Or is it going to be chasing after the fish, right? Well, I know a lot of spear fishermen will come up from that dive and their buddy ain't there because they chased after the fish, right? Instead of making sure that you didn't die, right? So a good friend of mine, Jeremy Gamble, owner of Spearing Magazine, the way he handles that, if he sees that happening, he's like, you selfish prick, right? You just told me that you shooting that fish is more important than making sure that I don't die, so you're never allowed on the boat and have fun on the rest of the boat the rest of the day, like you're on the boat the rest of the day, right? So we want to dive with people that have a safety-first mentality. All right, so let's take a look at what you're supposed to do if someone does have a loss of motor control or a blackout. That's the problem. All right, let's see. What was I doing? Oh yeah, so I actually show you how this works. So let me make me go away, put here. Look at that. So this is actually direct footage from freedivingsafety.com. So this is what, when you go to freedivingsafety.com, this is what it looks like. You've got all your, you've got the video and all the different modules and courses, because it is, like most things I do, it is extremely thorough. Where is the stupid video? This ain't it. There we go. All right. Out of curiosity, can someone let me in the comments? Can you see the pointer that I have? I don't know if that shows up on the screen or not. But anyway, so you see these are, this is part of freedivingsafety.com. You've got all this stuff, the three main safety principles, learn what to do if you dive in bad visibility, recovery breathing, my bulletproof buddy system, what's hyperventilation, why you should avoid it, what might you see before a blackout, how to handle the blackout, why you should remove your snorkel, why this rescue is different than what I teach in my course, which I'll talk about. So there's all sorts of stuff. And then I have two articles that I wrote for Spearing Magazine discussing how to hunt in teams. And then the other one is that one is the very best article that I've ever written. Is the myth of I know my limits. I don't push myself. I'm in tune with my body. Therefore, I don't need a buddy. I'm not worried about all the safety stuff. All right, so what we're going to do right now is I'm going to just roll the video and it's going to show you what this blackout rescue looks like. So do me a favor, let me know in the comments if you can see this. Hook bass. That's so CJ Duffy from Neuretic Pole Spear. So we're simulating having a loss of motor control in a blackout.
So I'm keeping his area out of water. This hand's going to grab his neck, place him on his back. Now I'm going to remove that mask. And now we're going to do a little tap top. Breathe for me, breathe. Breathe for me, breathe. Breathe for me, breathe. Right? And that's the idea. It's that simple.
All right, so I'm going to turn that sound off. And I'm going to play this again and kind of talk through it. All right, so soon as that person has the blackout, well, obviously, so this is CJ from Neuretic, right? So obviously, as soon as he comes up, you see that shaking. That means he's having a loss of motor control. So the first thing I'm doing, so first off, I'm close enough to grab. As soon as I see that, right? I mean, that's obvious something's not right, right? We call it loss of motor control for a reason, because the person's shaking. Okay, thanks. So now I know that they don't see that. All right, so he's having that loss of motor control. So what I did is I put my arm, the hand that you can't see is under his armpit to provide upwards force. And then the other hand you can see very clearly is sitting above the water, right? And it's not touching him in any way. I'm not grabbing his chin. I'm not grabbing his throat. The only reason that hand is there is in the future, if this were to turn into a blackout, his head is going to fall into my hand. And I'm keeping his airway from going into the water. All right. So the number one rule in free diving is protect the airway. So the reason I had that hand there is so that if he were to black out, I would catch it that way. All right. So let me put this back up. I don't have to turn this stuff off because it's making things laggy. Bear with me. All right, so let me put this back up. All right, there we go. All right, so now I catch his hand, boom. The Koopa catches his head. Then my other hand comes on the back of his neck, and all I do is just put him on his back. That's simple, right? Boom, he's on his back, okay? So at that point, now that I've got him on his back, the next step is, this is getting so laggy. The next step is, to take his mask off, right? So you're gonna see, I put him on his back, take his mask off, boom, right? Then the next step is gonna be what we call blow, tap, talk. This is what's gonna actually bring the person back, right? So I'm gonna tap him on his cheek. I'm gonna blow strongly across both of his eyeballs, and I'm going to encourage him to breathe, right? So we call it blow, tap, talk. Three things, three times. And that's the idea. All right, so I'm gonna shut all this stuff down and see if I can get this lag to go away, because the video is for sure lagging. Okay, so you guys let me know if I'm reading things correctly. The audio is fine, but now the video is lagging. Is that correct? Can you let me know in the comments? So anyway, I'm pretty sure, I don't see it in the comments, but I'm pretty sure that's what's happening. Yeah. All right, so because of that, that just drives me insane. It drives me insane. I'm just gonna cut this thing down. But basically, I got what I wanted to get done, right? So you guys learn what the loss of motor control, the blackout rescue looks like, how to do it. I think when I put all that other video on, it made everything get laggy because the internet connection is spot on. So anyway, I will be back the next Tuesday. Freedive Live will be Thursday at 7 p.m. Don't know why it's lagging, but I'm definitely going to cut it off because it's going to drive me and you guys crazy. Hope you guys enjoyed the episode. If there's buddies that need to see this, put them in the comments so they know they can at least learn how to save someone if they had a lost emotional rescue. And hope to see some of you guys tomorrow, 7 p.m. See you guys.